When I first saw Skara, I knew I would like him. But there was a huge problem. My wishing luck sucks, and I've lost pretty much all of my 50-50s. But this time was different, because I used the Forbidden Ritual to get myself Scaramouche, and to hopefully hit over 100,000 damage with him. Everyone's gonna come here and sacrifice Raiden, because I guess Scaramouche and Raiden have a pretty good relationship, right? So if you kill Raiden over here, you're gonna get Scaramouche. But wait, you know what? Everyone's gonna do this, right? This place would have no luck. So what I'm gonna do instead is that I'm gonna go to the Raiden statue and then sacrifice, I don't know, Raiden herself and maybe get a Scaramouche. Also, you must be thinking, why am I pulling for Scaramouche? I literally made like a Hazo video a couple of days back. So here are three reasons why I'm pulling for Scaramouche. He has a big hat, he has a hot mom, and the final reason, I want to recreate that, you know, that flying meme where the guy's like floating in the back and the guy's running away from him. Yeah, I want to recreate that meme. Also, I'm wearing a ring today because apparently Scaramouche has like a ring in his like finger. So yeah, I'm recreating everything. If this boy doesn't come home, dude, I don't know what to tell you, man. I need to kill her, right? What? She did zero damage? Alright, all I want is a Scaramouche and like C6 Fire Song, please. 25 pity? Let's fucking go. Four stars, that's fine. Four stars. As long as it's like a Farzan. Let's go! This ritual works! Another one, how it was? Oh! C1 off the bat! Let's go, two Farzans! This is 55? Can we get three more Farzans, please? Oh. Dude, I have like C99 Yawn Face. I don't want any more, man. That's a W pull. 3-4 stars? I want the 5 star Hazo. Power Zone right here. Watch this. Power Zone right here. What the? Power Zone? Dude, why does Farzan look like a VTuber avatar? This is the one, I think. This is Pity. This is Pity, I think. Do not call him Scaramouche, alright? Do not call him Scaramouche. He's gonna run away, alright? Bro has been through a lot. And you guys call him Scaramouche? This is Pity. Gold! Yay! This better be Scaramouche! I'm gonna treat that boy with love. This better be Scaramouche.
Let's fucking go!
Oh, back to back! Geo Farza. And now that I've gotten him and used him for a week, let's talk about his pros, his cons, and some other cool facts that I'm sure you don't know about. So, Scaramouche's launch has been really positive. Besides the Farzan energy issues, we don't talk about that. And from what I've seen, people like him a lot. He's not the strongest DPS by any means, but with that being said, he's not weak either. His kit has some issues, which we'll talk about later, but his damage feels good. He's not broken or bad, he's just an all-around balanced character. Also, I really appreciate the fact that with Sith, the weapon that you're probably using on him right now goes really well with his design. And on top of that, the gliders that we get at the start of the game match his drip really well. One small detail that you might have missed about him is about his breathing. For example, if you were to take your character to a cold place like Dragonspine, you would notice that they have this breath that you can see near their mouth. But this is not visible for Skara, because he's not human, so he doesn't need to breathe. The same thing also happens with Raiden Shogun, because she's a puppet. Now, speaking of his mom, you probably know that she's a big fan of sweets, but Skara is the exact opposite. In fact, his least favorite thing to eat are sweets.
I'm no fan of Dongo. Or any other sticky sweets that make me feel like my teeth are fusing together.
But he loves bitter food, which happens to be the opposite of sweets. And now, let's not forget about the most unique part of his kit that kinda lets him use creative mode, his elemental skill. This is by far the goofiest skill in the game, and I've never laughed harder while playing Genshin.
That looks goofy as well. Look at that, bro! What is going on?
But now, let's look at the most controversial and arguably the most important question about Skara. Is he taller than Xiao?
Oh hell no, brother pulled out Xiao. Alright, who's taller? Look at that, they're the same height, right? I mean, Scaramouche has a hat, so technically he's taller, but yeah.
Well, technically, Skara is taller because of his hat, but if you count Xiao's single strand of hair, he would be considered taller. So take your pick. But this is enough Skara praise, let's not forget about his cons. So you must have seen this idle animation where he pulls out an animal ball and acts as if he's gonna hit us. I'm pretty sure that he does this to mock his mom because Raiden also has a very similar ball idle animation. And I'd be lying if I were to say I liked Scarra's. Don't get me wrong, this animation is great. I mean, it captures his personality really well, but the growling sound effect he makes while doing it is annoying as hell. If you thought Shao's growling was bad, you will not be able to stand Scarra's. But hey, at least we can solve this problem with a single press of a button. Also, when I first saw his gameplay, I thought because he has a hovering ability that lets him float high up in the air, he would be able to avoid enemy attacks. But oh my god, I was so wrong. This guy is very reliant on shielders, and playing him without one is not a fun experience. In fact, I would go as far as to say that Wanderer without a shielder is a much worse experience than Nioimiya without a shielder. And finally, the last thing that really pisses me off about the Wanderer is his constellations. If you don't know, his constellations are pretty good. And my personal favorite is the C6 because it gives him more time to float, which means that he can play him for longer and attack more. And it kinda sucks that this is a C6 because most of the Scarra mains will never get even close to getting it. I'm pretty sure that HoYoverse knew that Scarra mains have been saving for a long time for the boy. They decided to put this one at last because they knew that Scarra mains would go all out on him. But this is just a baseless theory, so let me know what you think about this below. But now, this is enough talk. Let's look at something that you're here for, the damage. So enjoy my quest of trying to make Scarra the strongest animal boy in all of Genshin.
I have 3 goals for today's stream. The first one is hit 35k with Paramush's normal attacks, 50k with his ultimate, and the third, the most difficult one, many would call it impossible even, hit 75 or maybe 100k with his charge attacks. But first, before we do the damage showcase, let's look at my Scaramouche's build. I have 73 crit rate, 220 crit damage. I think we can ascend Scaramouche, right? That'll give him more crit rate as well. Yeah, let's do that. With Ascension, we got like 4% extra crit rate, right? Of course, I have the R5 with it, and these are the artifacts. This is the feather. Pretty good, I would say. Overall, pretty good pieces. No constellations, of course. Yeah, that's pretty much it. But we need to raise our Faruzan, though. Yeah, my Faruzan's build needs help. It needs help. For the weapons, let's give her the Skyward Harp. I think Favonius might be better. Give her a Fab Bow. You need a lot of gear. You know what? I'll give her a Fab Bow. Might have to steal this from Yulon. So I don't think her level should matter that much. I think the only thing that matters right now is just like talents. Let's raise this talent to like the max we can. Animal damage increased by 28%. Okay. What constellation is your Faruzan? She is C4. She's C4. You know what? Now let's check out like Scaramouche's like unbuffed damage real quick. Yeah. We had slimes over here, right? Oh yeah, they're there. $4,000 to $3,000. Is that good damage or is that bad damage? I don't know. Oh, let's try it with Faruzan's buff. Wait a second. Let's try it with Faruzan's buff. Yeah, let's do the burst. So basically, his damage went from 4,000 to 6,000. But that still seems kind of low, right? Is something wrong with my build? Or did I forget? Oh, ain't no way. Dude, I forgot to upgrade the talents again? Hold on, should we do 7, 7, and 7? Or should we do 8, 8, or 6? Yeah, let's do 7, 7, 7. And now finally, this is the final one. 7, 7, and 7. This should be good enough, right? This should be good enough. Now we can test out his like damage with like a proper build. Let's go. Hold on. Let's go to the Cryo Regiswine then. We do this. So he's doing 7k, right? He was doing 4k with level 1 talents, right? So his damage increased by 3k. That's pretty good. But now let's do the proper showcase. I need to hit 30,000 damage with Scaramouche. So let's go. 23k. I think we are getting close. This was with the attack buff, right? If we get the elemental bonus, I think we can hit 35k. Do you have Yunjin build? Oh yeah, I do have Yunjin build. Wait a second. Actually, Yunjin might be better than Zhongli. Yo, that was a great idea. Hold on a second. Yeah, because Yunjin gets like normal attack bonus, so she might be better than Zhongli Shred. Let's do that. Oh my god, dude, look at that! 36k! Dude, let's fucking go! Dude, we killed that challenge! Holy! Next challenge is to hit 50k with this burst. So let's do it. Also, we need to change the build a little bit. So I think we can give him like some Noblesse pieces like this one. And the goblet, Noblesse goblet. Animal damage. Look at these goblets, my G. A quick look at my artifacts. Yeah, and let's check out the, let's pick the ratios real quick. 69 to 231? Not too bad. Honestly, not too bad. Should we go to that guy? Let's go to the fat dude. I'm pretty sure that he's not gonna crit even once. So we can place a waypoint. Oh, yeah. That was 40k, right? 40k. That was with elemental buff as well. So I think to hit like 50k, I think I need to use Mona. Yeah, Mona should give us like thrilling tales and stuff like that. So yeah, let's do Mona. Let's do Mona. Wait a second. Was my Bennett using the wrong weapon? Oh my god, dude! That is why he was doing low damage. We were hitting 40k, right? So let's see how much damage we can do now. There was 45k, holy! Is there any other way to increase his damage? What is my Mona using? She's using... Oh, dude, she was using the prototype Amber? Wait, if I give her the Thrilling Tales, that would increase his damage even more. Yeah, let's do that. Fate is upon you. Wretched vermin. 46k, I think that was with the attack buff, right? 46k with the attack buff? I think it's possible now. You know what? I was scoping at first, but I think it's possible. Oh, he still has the attack buff. Are you serious? Again, the attack buff? Is this rigged? Is this actually rigged? Dude, imagine. This is how Eula mains feel. I feel sad for them now. I'll never bully a Eula main again. You know what? Let's give him the Solar Pearl and then give him the Wizard back. Surely this will work, right? Surely. Ooh. Ooh. 50k, let's go! Dude, switching the Witcher work! Let's fucking go! Now, for the final challenge, many would call it impossible, and this is by far the hardest thing I think we'll do today, is to hit 100k with his, like, charge attack. So, you know what? Let's do that. For this one, I think we're gonna use the same team. You know what? Let's go back to the Pyro Regiswine, yeah? Let's go back to the Pyro Regiswine. Let's see the unbuffed damage that we can do. For his charge attack, try switching to Wanderers, got a 75% charge attack bonus. I don't think my wizards are, like, that good. But I think for the charge attack showcase, I think I'm gonna have to switch back to my old artifacts. I think it was like a Crimson Witch one, right? Yeah, it was this one. And the goblet was... It was a onset goblet, right? Animal damage bonus. Yeah, two-piece and two-piece. Yeah, we're back. 77 to 221. Yeah, this should be good enough. Yeah, let's just try how it is, like, unbuffed charge attack first, and then we can mess around with, like, buffs and stuff. 12k, okay. Yeah, we have a long way to go. We have a long, dude. Honestly, I don't think 100k is possible. But wait, what if we do with, like, elemental bonuses and stuff? Let's try with buffs now. Dude, 60k? Are you serious? From 12k to 60k? Holy shit, maybe, you know what? 100k maybe is possible now. Bro, you're missing tenacity on Mona. I could give Mona tenacity. Yeah, you're right. Oh, you know what? We can go to the Raiden boss fight. And because on her weakened state, she has lower resistance. So I think that'll give us the maximum numbers. So let's do that. Let's do that. Sided by destiny. 75. Dude, that was 73. 82. Dude. Bro, 82 kills. Let's fucking go. No tenacity, dude. Oh, yeah. Oh, I forgot to use the tenacity set. With tenacity, that would have been even higher, right? Now, you must be thinking, how will I turn my 82k into 100k? Well, we take the Adeptus Temptation, and then we take the Essential Oil, which gives us more damage. Shut up. No, we don't have to talk about this. This does not have to go in the video. We got the EM buff. No. With the EM buff, we were getting like 70k, right? And that does not increase damage at all. Even with the attack buff, we might be able to pull it off. Dude, 100k! Let's fucking... Let's fucking go! Yeah, Scaramouche was the first Asian kid to, like, fight his mom and survive. If you're watching right now and if you want to join me next time, be sure to subscribe and also follow my Twitch because I do challenges like these over there as well. See everyone. Bye-bye. Bye-bye, everyone. Bye-bye.